Today afternoon, we are very happy to have with us Captain Shashank, Merck's Global Head of Crewing and Marine HR, YMS, and this is on the 25th year of celebration of the Institute of Maritime Studies and the first shipping dignitary whom we are able to interact with. So, welcome, sir.
Thank you so much.
So, can you inform us about your journey from your cadetship right up to this position now, which you hold?
So, first of all, thank you so much for having this interview and inviting me here. I was planning to make visit to IMS for quite some time, and for some reason I couldn't. But I'm happy that I managed to come here. That too on a 25th year anniversary of the institute, this great institute. We have many, many seafarers sailing in our company who have alumni of this good institute. Talking about my personal career, I started my career in 1990 with a Norwegian company called Bergesen. After passing out from T.S. Rehman, where I did my cadetship, I spent 7 years with Bergesen, where I did cadetship second officer up to second officer. Subsequently, I changed a couple of companies. I got my command in 2001, and then I continued sailing till 2012, mainly on gas tanker, on containers, bulk carriers, and tankers. So I was fortunate to sail on different types of vessel. Finally, I quit sea in 2012 and moved to Singapore, for where I was there for a couple of years. After working there, in safety and quality department in a couple of companies, I came back to India to head Maersk Tankers and Maersk Line together to look after India and Southeast Asia. So, as a part of separation from APM Group, Maersk Tanker became separate from APM Group, and that is where we have set up a new office in Vikhroli, where basically we take care of all the energy sector, which is Maersk Tanker is part of. November 2018, I was promoted to Global Head of Crewing and Marine HR. So my present responsibility basically includes taking care of approximately 3,400 seafarers, which we have globally, including India and Southeast Asia. And then me and my team of 34 people, we basically take care of global manning. So we are well supported by about 18 third-party agencies across the globe. And there are good prospects, many new projects which we are undertaking to see the typical crewing to go from a conventional crewing to a new technically advanced things, which is basically benefiting our seafarers.
Very illustrious career you have. In fact, now you are come to a position where really reaching the top level of your career. So, how many ships do you man from Mumbai itself?
So, Maersk Tanker, basically, along with Maersk Tanker, we own and we manage ships of five different owners. So, we are also, you can say, third-party technical manager. Presently, we have 85 vessels, which we do the technical management. And basically, I have done some changes in the organization, where the entire crewing team basically operates from India. So, this is one of the good thing, where all the crewing team sits under one roof and carry out all the operations globally. And like I mentioned, we are well supported by third-party agencies across the globe. So it is very easy. Last 18 months or so, we are working from home, where we have, that is another thing which we have learned due to this pandemic, that it doesn't matter where the location is, as long as you have a good connectivity, good network and gadgets, it is easy to do ship operations from anywhere in the world.
So that's wonderful that you are setting up base in India, and this will be more advantageous for the Indian seafarers itself. So can you mention that how did you find your visit in IMS? Means how it went?
Yes. So like I was actually looking forward to this trip for quite some time. And it was bad on my part that I couldn't take out time and visit this great campus, great institute. So I'm definitely very happy. My thought about the institute definitely We, like I mentioned, we have many good seafarers who are already sailing with us. One of the intention is, of course, that how we can, you know, place our cadetship program. So right now, India is one of our key sourcing area, and definitely we will be, you know, looking at increasing the pool of Indian seafarers, which are, you know, also globally accepted. So definitely IMS will be on the list where, you know, we can look into getting our future cadets from. And we have a very robust cadetship program, which basically happens before they join us as cadet and then subsequently during their training days. So using that, I think we should be able to filter out and carry out our recruitment process in future whenever we come to IMS.
That's very nice. So we are very happy that you would be planning to come to IMS to think about taking cadets from our college. We do have our the GME and DME programs, so which you already are aware of. And we expect that in the future we will have some real tie-up with you, and Merck's and IMS would maybe get the best support from the engineers which will be trained in IMS. So thank you, sir, for being here. It is a pleasure that after so many years of interaction when trips to Bombay, now we are able to interact in Goa. And have a safe trip, and thank you for being here.
It's my pleasure. Thank you so much.